much better. I had an interesting aha. Eureka! It was very exciting yesterday evening. During my therapy session, I came into the therapy session video chat not having a whole lot of clarity of what I wanted to talk about. I really felt confused. I wasn't sure how I felt about things. I was back and forth on wanting to agree with my husband, but wanting to stand up for myself. I couldn't fathom the healthy way of thinking. I couldn't process what would be healthy. I felt like I was betraying myself. And my therapist walked me through it and helped me realize that there is a healthy middle, like a gray. It's not so black and it's not so white. It doesn't have to be so drastic on either end. And we came up with this visual analogy. I explained it to my husband last night too, and I think he totally got it. I think he totally understands it. He was supportive and listening and loving and helpful and provided his own insight, and it was pretty eye-opening to me, and it was a really good bonding wordy moment where we were just using words to bond and relate to each other, and it was really awesome. So I had a really good night last night. Now, without taking my eyes off the road, I'm going to do this all from peripheral vision. It's not that page. Somewhere in the center. There we go. This is what I drew during my therapy session yesterday. It's called Conversation Islands or Compromise Island. So way over here you have me, who doesn't want to be codependent anymore, who's tired of it, wants to be at a zero as far as codependence level goes. And then way over here is my husband, where if I do everything his way, I feel like I'm at a 10 for codependence. And I don't want to do anything his way. I want to be my own person. So even if I agree with him on something, eventually, but I don't agree with him initially, or I'm looking for opportunities to hold my assertiveness and independence, and I want my own opinion, so I'm trying to put myself on the opposite scale as him, on the opposite side as him. It's basically like me being on my own island and him being on his own island, and he'll say to me, no, we're going to do it this way. And I'm like, no, I am not giving in anymore. You're coming over to my island, bub. And he's like, oh, you want to know how wrong you are? Let me tell you how wrong you are. And he wants me to come all the way to his island. And so my visual analogy that me and my therapist came up with together is that when you're in a relationship, it's not about your individual islands and, okay, fine, we'll go to your island now. Okay, fine, we'll go to your island now. I mean, it might be like that for some things, right? Like, whose parents' house do we go to for Thanksgiving, sort of thing? Okay, we'll do your parents' this year, but next year we're doing mine. That's probably giving in all the way for one at a time. But the compromise is that you get to do, the compromise is that it gets to go back and forth. It gets to be a little bit of both. You know what I mean? So, it was just eye-opening to me that I don't have to be completely independent and completely assertive while I'm still in a marriage. I can creep over to a 1 or a 2 or a 3 or a 4 or a 5. And I could even, if I should choose, do a 6 or a 7 or an 8. I don't have to do it all or nothing. I can do a little bit of mine, a little bit of his. And it's going to be, of course, situational, bit by bit. Anyway, I'm at work, and I just wanted to talk about that real quick. And I thought it was brilliant. And I think I'm done now. Good to you all. Later. Bye-bye.